the man accused of barreling into a woman at a stoplight and killing her makes his first court appearance on the same day that friends and family say goodbye to 30-year-old Tiffany Mogensen. Peggy Bright is live with the latest developments. Peggy?
Laura, the collision course ended right back here on Friday afternoon. This is the intersection of 75th and Row. Tonight, the man accused in the case is jailed on $200,000 bond. 31-year-old Roy Maney made a video court appearance accused of involuntary manslaughter. He told the judge he'd be hiring his own attorney. Distraught relatives and friends of Maney's were in attendance and were confronted by a friend of 30-year-old Tiffany Mogensen, who was killed in the crash. The friend lashed out in pain. Relatives didn't respond but cried even harder. It's the fallout from this horrendous collision. Police say Maney was driving fast in a 2009 Mercedes when they saw him blocks earlier. They tried to stop him, but he accelerated. They did not chase. But minutes later, they say Maney lost all control and crashed. He ran, and they caught him a few blocks away. Court documents say he was driving under the influence of alcohol. One man tells us he was here in the aftermath, and he can't forget it.
I haven't seen car damage that bad, except on a super highway, like an interstate, where everybody's going fast. Here it was in a residential zone.
Sven Allstrom says he thinks about the man accused.
We don't know where his mind was, but it was in a dangerous place.
But Tiffany's friends and family are focusing on their goodbyes tonight. Funeral services just underway. Her Blue Springs Dance Studio Facebook page is overflowing with sadness, but also fond memories for the former Chiefs cheerleader, loving wife, and stepmom. Now, Tiffany Mogensen's husband, Mike, issued a statement today thanking the community for its outpouring of support. He says condolences have come in from across the country. Today is the couple's 18-month wedding anniversary. We're live at 75th and Row. Peggy Bright, KMBC 9 News.
And Maney is due back in court on October 24th.